Well, it's raining exclusives on CNBC-TV18, and CNBC-TV18 News break confirmed as Baring PE Asia to buy 30% stake in NIIT Tech. Nimesh Shah and Reema Tendulkar join us early this morning to tell us all the details. Reema, first coming to you, tell us what are the details of this deal and what does this mean for both the companies?
Thanks, Anisha. Well, as CNBC-TV18 has been reporting, Barings has now acquired NIIT Technology. They have acquired the entire promoter stake of 30.5% in NIIT Technology. They value it at 1,394 rupees per share, which is at a 3% premium to where the stock closed in Friday's trade, which was around 1,350. Barings will also make an open offer to acquire an additional 26% stake, again at 1,394 rupees per share. So overall, Barings will have a 56% stake, and the overall consideration is just shy of that 5,000 crore rupees or $700 million.
All right, Reema, thanks a lot for that. So now we come to two big questions as a result of that. First, what happens to NIIT Limited? What will it do with the money? Nimesh, the cash received by NIIT would be more than 2,000 crores and the market cap is close to around 1,600 crores.
Oh, yes, madam. So this has been going on for a very long time that, you know, eventually NIIT Tech will be sold out and there will be a big cash inflow into NIIT Limited. That's why NIIT Limited will be also in focus in today's trade. If you just look at the numbers, NIIT Limited owns 1.44 crore shares of NIIT Tech, which is close to 23.5% stake, and at a price of 1394 at which the deal is announced, NIIT Limited will get an inflow of close to 2020 crores versus the Friday's market cap of 1600 crores. So clearly there is the cash will be quite high on the books of NIIT Limited now. What this means for NIIT Limited now: one, the holding company discount will go away. So for a long time, you know, there was a discount because of the fact that they were holding and it was not, sold into, there was a discount into it. So now that discount will vanish. So that's the first thing to watch out for. Second, and as you rightly pointed out, Mangalam, the key will be what will the promoters do or what will be the, what will be the outgo of the money that they're getting in from the stake sale. So, and the other important thing to watch out is that in NIIT Limited, the promoter holding is 31.5%. So if promoters needs money, maybe one of the options which has been speculated in the market is there will be a one-time special dividend to reward the investors. So that is something to watch out for. If there is a proper strategy spelled by the promoters to what they're going to do with this money, I think the stock can get re-rated. So watch out for that. But clearly, big move is expected in NIIT Limited today because the money that they've got is more than the market cap. And the fact that there is no speculation that there will be a one-time big dividend because of the money that they've got from selling stake in NIIT Tech.
Okay, so need to watch out for the cash utilization of NIIT Limited. But that brings us to the second question. Now, Reema, is there a possibility that Barings would look to merge Hexaware and NIIT Tech as a result of this deal?
Well, that is an option. There are three key things now for NIIT Technology that you need to bear in mind. One, Barings PE has acquired it at a fairly high multiple. So they have acquired it. The valuation at 1394 is just about 2% away from its lifetime high of 1425 rupees. Also, they're valuing it at 18 times FY20P, which is much higher than the five-year average price. Also, what we've seen in the case, so when a PE company acquires a company, we see an increase in the cash, in the dividend, as well as buyout. So that's how a PE company reduces their acquisition price. So that is also something that, you know, NIIT Technology shareholders can possibly watch from Barings PE. Now, because Barings PE is acquired at a high price, it appears that it makes very less financial sense. Now, if a, you know, private equity company comes in with a limited time frame, you know, they're not someone who's in for the strategic game. So if you've entered at a high price, where do you get an exit? Mm. Do you get an exit at 24, 25? These are multiples you've not seen in IT company. So therefore, it brings us to the possibility that maybe they have a strategic rationale for it and therefore a merger with Hexaware. Barings has a 62.5% stake in Hexaware. So therefore, is an eventual merger on the cards. A combined company will have a $1.2 billion revenue and the businesses are complementary. Both of them are strong in travel and transportation. NIIT Tech is stronger in UK, Europe, while Hexaware has more of the North American clients. Also, the BFS, Banking Financial Services, is stronger for Hexaware, while insurance is stronger for NIIT Technology. So overall, there are synergies in the business. Another big question is, which CEO stays on? Now, NIIT Technology has had a patchy track record if you look at the last 8 years or 10 years or something. But in the last few years, the company has done well under Sudhir Singh. So which CEO stays on? And on your screen, you will also see, what the combined entity will look like in terms of revenues as well as margins.
So, I just wanted to add one point to what Reema had said. The last line, you know, about the combined entity. So I spoke to a couple of investors and some analysts as well on what it means. The sense I'm getting is going forward, you're going to see this trend. Globally, I'm told you need a size of at least $1 billion in revenues to go out and look for larger larger deals in future. So that probably is the rationale why you're seeing a lot of mid-cap consolidations happening. You saw you know, L&T buying out Mindtree and now this. So essentially, the target for all these companies would be to have a size of at least $1 billion in terms of revenues across 3-4 verticals to make sure that they go out and pitch for larger contracts going forward.
Okay, but I just want to add, creating size doesn't always mean that you're creating value for shareholders, because sure, there are many large IT companies who are actually trading at low multiples because growth is not there. So for any company, I guess growth is paramount.
All right. Thanks a lot for that, both Reema and Nimesh. We will keep an eye out on how this story plays out. Three companies, NIIT Technologies, NIIT Limited, and Hexaware. With that, we move on to yet another CNBC-TV18 news break, which is confirmed. Future Consumer acquires some brands and businesses from Athena Life Sciences. Priya Sheth joins us on the phone line with more. Priya?
Well, absolutely in line with what we had reported on February 8th, Future Consumer and its board meet held yesterday has announced the acquisition of personal care brands of Athena Life Sciences. Now, these brands include the like of Iraya, Hair for Sure, D3, and many more, and these will be merged with Future Consumer's personal care business. Now, do remember that Future Consumer has brands like Mibel as well as Think Skin, which are a part of its personal care business at this point in time. Now, this also marks the entry of Future Group into the Ayurveda space. The deal is, of course, subject to regulatory approvals, which includes both brands as well as distribution. Now, this acquisition will help Future Consumer expand its presence in the high margin categories of hair care as well as skin care, and the products are expected to be available across the Future Group network of Big Bazaars, Nilgiri's, Easy Day, Heritage Fresh, etc. Now, another important outcome of the board meet yesterday was a fundraising announcement where Future Consumer announced plans to raise about 350 crore rupees from existing investors, that's IFC as well as World Invest, as well as its promoters. Now, if you break this up, it will mean that about 210 crore will come from IFC, 70 crore rupees each will come from World Invest as well as promoters. So therefore, these funds will be used towards expansion as well as other business initiatives, as well as part of it to cut debt.
Okay, Priya, thank you so much for that. And Mangalam, what's your take on terms of the valuation of this deal as well as this fundraising that they have announced?
Well, it looks like, you know, they've raised this 350 crore rupees to acquire Athena. And if that's the sort of money that they've paid for Athena, then it looks like they've overpaid for Athena, for the simple reason that FY18, the net worth of Athena Life Sciences was close to around 98 crores. Last 3 years, the sales have only declined from 18 crores in FY16 to 17 crores in FY17 to just about 4 crores in FY18. Even if you take a last 3 year average sales, it would be around 13 crore rupees. So the big question is, why is the company paid 4x book and 27x 3 year average sales? Is there a fair amount of scalability that they see for this or not, is the big question. The 350 crore, I hope not all of that is put towards acquisition of this. So the valuation is most important, because if they have acquired this for 350 crore rupees and it is a compulsorily convertible debenture that they've given, just look at about 10% interest on that. 35 crore rupees is the interest outgo, and the sales of the last 3 years have only been 13 crores. So let's hope that not all of this 350 crores has been directed towards acquiring this. So valuation, very important. With that, we move on to an update from JET. Sources say SBI led banks to invite expression of interest for stake sale in JET Airways today. Ritu joins us on the phone line with more. Ritu?
Well, you know, Mangalam, there's a bit of a delay on the lenders end. They initially indicated that the EOIs would be invited on the 6th of April, that is on Saturday, but finally today is when we're seeing the bankers open the process for inviting, bidders for stake sale in JET Airways. Now, as we, told our viewers yesterday, rather, the EOI document that we've accessed shows that the bids will be invited starting today, and the deadline has also accordingly been extended. So instead of 9th of April, which was initially set as the deadline, 10th of April is when the bidding date will close, which means players that are interested can submit expressions of interest until the 10th of April. The delay we're given to understand is because of some legal clearances as well as approvals from RBI that the lenders were awaiting. But given that, 2 days had already lapsed over the weekend, the EOI document has now been put out in the public forum for bids to be invited. Do remember, we have reported earlier that players like TPG, Indigo Partners, NIIF may look to submit bids together. Banks have also reached out to some other foreign airlines. But it remains to be seen that by the end of the 10th of April, who are the players that actually come forward?